Blackstone Publishing presents Reagan, the American President by Larry Schweikart. This book is read by Robert Scott. Introduction. No angelic choirs sang, no star in the east seduced curious magi to snowy Tampico, Illinois, the night Ronald Wilson Reagan was born, contrary to the mythology of some biographers. His father only differentiated that night from the birth of his other son, Neil, by blurting out that the newborn had a face as red as a Dutchman's, bequeathing a nickname that stuck with Ronald his entire life. Dutch's entrance into this world was not charged by supernatural signs, nor, as he grew up, was his life characterized by the typical trappings of one destined for the list of history's greatest names. His family lacked wealth, connections, or prestige. As a young man, he didn't attend Harvard or Yale, and he was not a lawyer, often seen as the defining profession for a politician. It was, in fact, precisely the absence of these elements that provided young Ronald Reagan with the most normal of lives, and even when his career elevated him to movie star status, his position as the head of a major American labor union once again placed him closer to the experiences of ordinary people than the vast majority of the politicians with whom he soon circulated. By a sequence of life steps, Reagan embodied almost every touchstone of a typical American. He worked at low-level jobs like lifeguard and radio announcer. He went to an unknown school and had marginal grades. He experienced a failed marriage. When forced out of one career path, he reinvented himself in another, and then another. He served in the military. He was a born-again Christian when it was common. He was a member of a labor union. These remarkable twists and turns made Reagan unique among all American presidents, for he was the first to ever lead a student strike, the first to be divorced, the first to be in a union, and the first actor president. And these characteristics, combined with a natural talent for remembering lines, for geniality, for genuine Christian charity and concern, for self-deprecation, for personal heroism, and yes, for some necessary self-promotion to magnify and then reflect his lifetime back on ordinary American voters. Why did Reagan connect? How could he not? In 2016, when pundits and experts were dumbfounded at the success of a new, very different version of Reagan, Donald Trump, the perceptive among them would admit there were very many similarities, especially when speaking to and for the common man. In his speeches, Reagan often referred to Joe America, and in his inaugural address, Trump said to the Republican convention and all ordinary, forgotten Americans, "I am your voice." Their backgrounds were hardly identical, but the appeal was very much the same. Trump, the glamorous billionaire, Reagan, the glamorous movie star. Critics would claim Trump was brash and reckless, forgetting that Reagan, while using a self-effacing humor as a sword, well, there you go again, was often attacked as even more reckless. One biographer claimed Reagan was sleepwalking through history. Occasionally in American history, an insider with the proper credentials, with wealth, and with all the chips on his side, can leap the chasm to the average person. Teddy Roosevelt did it. His cousin Franklin did it, and John Kennedy did it. Far more often, the gap remains, bridged by respect, but seldom love. Ronald Reagan elicited the affection that was seen in the lives of the presidents who were viewed as men of the people, Andrew Jackson, Abraham Lincoln, and Harry Truman. America's love and respect was on full display upon Reagan's death when his viewing produced endless lines, and the procession to his final resting place along California highways saw crowds with signs standing as adoring sentinels, mile after mile. Then again, in Washington, D.C., when the lines of mourners shocked the journalists who thought Reagan incompetent or even dangerous. Of course, when it comes to the need for a new Reagan biography, the question is, why? Who needs one? Despite some excellent work during Reagan's life and after his passing, no biography has yet captured the man and his ideas. Indeed, with once-in-a-lifetime access to the Gipper and his family.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.